Enjoy yourself. Welcome, 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 welcome to the Tonight Show. You're here. What a show tonight. Well, guys, today all eyes were on New Hampshire as they held the first presidential primary of 2024. And I'm just going to come out and say it. Things are really not looking good for Ron DeSantis. Yep, the New Hampshire primary is over, which means the candidates can stop pretending like they want to be in New Hampshire in January. It's so great to be here. It was a tense day for former President Trump. He spent all day wondering if he won New Hampshire or if the vote was rigged. That's right, Trump spent the day awaiting the verdict, although he's pretty much spent the last year and a half awaiting a verdict. He's used to it. And this is fun. The first votes in New Hampshire were cast in the historic town of Dixville Notch. And the town only has 6 registered voters. One is here tonight. And but since they're the first, they get a lot of attention, the Dixville Notch. In fact, Bravo even has a new reality show about them. Yeah, check this out.
I play hard, and I vote even harder.
I didn't come here to make friends. I came here to pick the next president.
I'm gonna turn the space heater in the corner of the high school gym all the way up.
Dixville Notch. You know, our town's name sounds really nasty, but I'm not sure why.
You know, we started this tradition 64 years ago when I was a boy.
I'm not what you would call mentally sound, but guess what? That's a you problem.
Welcome to Dixville, Niatch.
These are the registered voters of Dixville Notch.
Well, earlier today, Trump took to social media to make a final appeal to voters in New Hampshire, but he had a slight typo. He wrote, "I get much better poll numbers against Biden than Nikki Haley," not even close, P-O-L-E. He's like, "I've seen a lot of polls with a lot of women named Nikki on them. You had me at polls, you had me at Nikki, but you lost me at Haley." Meanwhile, in an interview with Fox News, Trump said that he would beat Nikki Haley on a cognitive test. Well, I guess she accepted his challenge because they both took a mental test, and we got the responses at the show.
Really?
Yeah, let's take a look at how they did. This first question asks, "What is the name of this animal?" Haley said, "A duck." Trump said, "Affleck." They're both taking the test. Next up, this one said, repeat this list of words. Face, velvet, church, daisy, red. Haley said, face, velvet, church, daisy, red. While Trump said, person, woman, man, camera, TV. He's like, yeah, I know that one. Remember if he did the old...
He did that old test, yeah.
The old joke?
Yeah.
Here's another one. It says, draw a box. Haley drew this while Trump drew this. And just... These are helpful tests. Next up, this question said, what time is on this clock? Haley said, 5:45 p.m., while Trump said, 69, nice. What? Wow. After that, it said, starting at 100, subtract by 7 5 times. Haley said, 100, 93, 86, 79, 72, 65. While Trump said, 193, pass, pass, goose. Goose. This question said, what state are you in right now? Haley said, New Hampshire, while Trump said, hungry and horny. What is it?
What? Really?
That's it. Look at this one. This question said, who is this historical figure? Haley said, Albert Einstein. Trump said, the grandpa from Willy Wonka. What is he talking about? I don't understand.
Why would he?
Here's another one. This question said, when does the sun come out? Haley said, during the day. Trump said, when he needs money from daddy. Oh.
S-O-N.
When the sun comes out. And finally, this question said, what should you do when you smell smoke? Haley said, call 911. Trump said, get out of the tanning bed. There you go. Well, interesting result. Interesting result. I'm glad we got them. Well, get this. Last night during a rally in New Hampshire, Trump started talking about a missile defense system that he wants to introduce in the U.S., and he did a pretty good job at explaining how it works. Watch this.
And they calmly walk to a seat. Ding, 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 ding. They've only got 17 seconds to figure this whole thing out, right? Boom. Okay. Missile launch. Pshing, poom.
What was that about a cognitive test? Enough with the technical talk. Can you put it in layman's terms? Ping, bing, bing, ding, ding, bong, boom, blowy. Blowy uppy. Later, Trump was like, bing, ding, bing, boom, that's Oppenheimer, and hubba, hubba, va, va, boom, that's Barbie, and, you know. And towards the end of the rally, when Trump was wrapping up his speech, it seemed like he got a little lost. Listen to this.
We have become a drug-infested, crime-ridden nation, which is incapable of solving even the smallest problem. The simplest of problems we can no longer solve. We can't do anything. We are an institute and a powerful death penalty. We will put this on.
It looks like someone who just woke up from having their wisdom teeth pulled. You know, and we'll walk up and talk to... With the primaries underway, both Trump and Nikki Haley have received several endorsements from politicians in Washington. For instance, Trump was just endorsed by Ron DeSantis, and Haley was just endorsed by New Hampshire's Governor Chris Sununu.
Yeah. Who cares?
Sorry. What was that, Trey?
I'm just saying, nobody cares about who some random-ass politician endorses. Like, who's going to vote for Trump because Ron DeSantis says to? Or who's going to vote for Haley because Governor Sununu says to? Their opinion means nothing.
So you don't care about endorsements from any politician?
No way whatsoever.
What about Rand Paul?
Not at all.
Tim Scott?
Psh, not.
Ted Budd?
Guy's a dud.
Steve Daines?
Got no brains.
J.D. Vance?
Not a chance.
Darren LaHood?
Wish I could.
Jim Banks?
No thanks.
Roger Wicker?
No worse picker.
Eli Crane?
Are you insane?
And Dale Strong?
Always wrong.
I said Jason Crow?
Hell no.
And Corey Mills?
You on pills?
Jack Reed?
You smoking weed?
Steve Scalise?
Bitch police!
Lloyd Smucker?
That mother f-
Hey, stop. Stop. Tariq Trotter, everybody. Tariq Trotter. I'm sorry, guys. Hey, I saw that today President Biden and Vice President Harris held their first joint campaign appearance of the year. Yep, apparently Biden's New Year's resolution was to meet new people. Hey, where have you been for 4 years? Switching gears, today the nominations were announced for the 96th Oscars. Ryan Gosling was nominated for playing Ken. He's got to pick up the statue like, something about this looks familiar. Some business news. Apple just rolled out a new security update to protect users' personal data from thieves. Apple put out a press release like, we wouldn't have to do this if you idiots wouldn't stop making your passcode 1234. Some more business news. Wendy's just added breakfast burritos to their menu. Yeah. I don't know. I just worry it won't be as authentic as the breakfast burrito I get from Taco Bell. I don't know if it'll be as authentic. You know it's a healthy breakfast when people are dipping it in a Frosty. Hey, I heard about a man in China who was disqualified from a marathon after he chain-smoked cigarettes the entire race. It was cute. Every few miles, they had tiny water cups for him to ash in. And finally, I know a lot of people find math boring. Well, that's why we've updated math to make the equations be about stuff that you can relate to. It's time for Popular Mathematics. Here we go. Let's take a look at the first equation here. If you take a baby hand plus Flamin' Hot Cheetos, it equals Trump's mystery rash. You get the idea? It's math problem. Here's another one. If you take Pizza Hut plus Sunglass Hut plus going on a long walk, it equals Hut hike. You see what I'm saying? Thank you. There's more. Here's another one. Gene Wilder. Mm-hmm. minus a dress shirt mm-hmm. plus a six-pack equals Jeremy Allen White. How about this one? If you take a gallon of water mm-hmm. plus a tool belt, it equals that person in front of you at TSA.
I can take it off?
Can't bring this on the... Beep! Here's another one. Millie Bobby Brown plus Millie Bobby Brown plus mm-hmm. Millie Bobby Brown plus Millie Bobby Brown plus Millie Bobby Brown plus Millie Bobby Brown plus Millie Bobby Brown equals 7-Eleven. Do you understand?
7-Eleven.
It's math. Yeah, it's making math fun.
But you made it fun, yeah.
Finally, if you take Jonah Hill plus a dry erase board, it equals Post Malone. There you go. That's all the time we have for popular mathematics. Hey, hey.